All right, 24 of the game. But just to set the tone of this wonderful video game that I love quite a lot, based on a show I love quite a lot. Let's watch the season 4 trailer.
24 season 4 on DVD.
There's a nuclear warhead gonna detonate somewhere over this country.
No! Get even more with an exclusive prequel that clues you in to next season. 24 season 4. Own it today.
I love that for some reason. So let's delete this save file and start fresh. What do you say? 24 is based on the hit TV show, of course. As you can see, it came out after season 3, and there's a trailer for season 4 you get if you bought the game. The story takes place between seasons 2 and 3 of 24. I believe they're currently coming out with season, like, well, they're redoing it, but... What I don't like about 24 the game is that it doesn't follow the show closely, even in little things like that.
The following takes place between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m.
Events occur in real time. Which is a thing they say on the show and not here, and that annoys me, but whatever.
This is Beta Leader. I have 2 armed guards patrolling the above decks. I don't know how many below. You're clear to continue in. But I want each and every position called. There's illegal arms shipments aboard and at least 200 kilos of the biotoxin ricin. Everything points to these people being on the defensive. If they even find out we're in the area, they'll blow the holds and release the toxin into the water system. Are we clear?
We copy you, Beta Leader. Beta Leader, they've got the ship rigged. We tripped the switch. They don't know we're here yet. They will soon.
Damn it. We're heading in. We need to get on board and stop the detonation of the ricin cargo. Maintain positions. We cannot afford to make any mistakes. Let's go!
Alright. So, 24, the TV show, stars David Hayter playing...
Spread out and take it slow.
Affirmative, sir.
Jack Bauer, who is a CTU agent, which is Counterterrorism Unit, a fictional government agency meant to fight terrorists. This game is meant to be a Grand Theft Auto-like, except that it follows a very linear format, like the show, so it doesn't really work out very well. Speaking of not working out very well, the camera's pretty terrible.
Taking cover. In position.
So we're gonna do this tutorial here for now. Before I nerd out about the show. This is a cool feature of the show. They do a lot of, like, fun split-screen type of things. The show takes place in real time, is the whole trick to it.
Hostile spotted.
Talk more about that when appropriate. So the way this works is you take cover with X, you hold L1 to aim, you flick the stick to switch targets, and you can slowly adjust. So they give you sort of auto aim, and then you can kind of adjust your headshots. Or not.
Hostile down.
This is, of course, the real cast, by the way. No, but really, though, 24 does do cool, like, split-screen stuff where it shows you, like, what another plot thread is happening while, you know, things like that. It's, again, the show's gimmick is that it took place in real time. This worked best for season 1 of 24.
Doors locked. Explosive breach needed.
And that's kind of it.
Charge.
In fact, the first season also starts at midnight, which technically means Jack's been up the whole night when it happens. And it's the only, like, episode that kind of acknowledges that he gets the only season that acknowledges he, like, gets tired and things like that. The rest of it, though, they just sort of forget. And he's fine, which I think is bullshit, but whatever. Let's restrain him. And take him down.
Hostile down.
I don't even know the point of that, Jack. Oops. Jack Bauer does like to scream at people quite a bit. If you've ever played the game Alpha Protocol, they have like 3 spy archetypes that a lot of people describe as James Bond, Jason Bourne, or Jack Bauer. his kind of gimmick is he's extremely ruthless. I don't think the show was ever meant to say, like, the way Jack Bauer does things is good. He's kind of a broken, fucked up guy. But, you know, people kind of take it to mean, oh, he's really cool. He gets the job done and all that shit. That said, it is a fun show and pretty gory and things like that. See here. Now, what other fun things can we talk about with 24? So, like I said, this takes place between seasons 2 and 3. There's an unavoidable season 1 spoiler, but I'll see how long I can avoid it because it is a pretty cool plot twist. In season 2 of 24, let's see. Jack. Well, spotted. It aired in 2002 after the September 11th attacks, and in it, Islamic terrorists in a group called, and I wish I were making this up, Second Wave. Attempt to detonate a nuclear device in Los Angeles. Jack Bauer is the only one who can stop them.
Yes, sir.
It was actually a very tense, cool show, and I would really recommend seasons 1 and 2. Season 3, quite a few things changed. They didn't really explain why, and this video game was meant to bridge that gap. And I'll try to explain that as that comes. Play SWAT 4.
It's an ambush.
24 usually kind of saves its cool action stuff for
hostile down.
Near the end of the season. I don't know what the point of capturing people is, by the way, as opposed to killing them, but whatever. It's usually not this super action-y where Jack is killing, like, tons of people at once, but, Which season had the guy who played the mummy as the villain? Is that season 4, I think, was with Marwan, yeah.
Do we know where the rice will be stored?
Will be stored.
One of the forward cargo holds.
Down.
All right, fun trick with this show, I'm going to tell you. If you look at this is not bad at all for PS2 graphics. I think Sony worked on this game. If you look at the cutscenes, though, they look pretty phenomenal for PlayStation 2. And in fact, there's a little bit of trickery going on. What the game does is they actually pre-render it on, like, a slightly more, like, powerful computer than a PS2, and they do stuff that the PS2 can't do, but they basically try to make it, like, look like, oh wow, look what we managed to do on the PS2, but it's all pre-rendered video. Sorry to have spoiled the trick there, but the truth must be told. How many seasons of 20 did 24 have? So I only watched through season 6 because I love, season 1 is really good. Season 2 is very good. I actually liked it better, though general consensus is 1 is the best one. 3, 4, and 5 kind of take a dip. I think 5 spikes up a little. Season 6 is just fucking garbage, and I stopped watching the show entirely. Funnily enough, I think that's, again, general consensus, because there was, like, sort of a made-for-TV movie, I think, or called 24 Redemption, which I feel like is almost an admission, like, yeah, that sucked, we're sorry. Oops.
Hostile down.
Uh-oh. 4 minutes.
Could be any minute. We've got to keep moving.
No, it's 4, Jack. I don't know how we know that, but... So there's an example of 24's kind of infamous split-screen thing. They don't do countdowns like that. They will show kind of like before the current time, you know? Uh-oh. Jack looks like he's just resting there. I've heard season 7's pretty good. I've heard 7 and 8 are actually pretty good. And I think they're coming out with a whole new series where Kiefer Sutherland, or Jack Bauer, I should say, is not in it. They always sort of teased killing Jack in it, although I don't really think they would have. Because they said, oh, well, time is the real villain of the show. Every season of 24 has something terrible in it, is my theory. And each... season 1, there is an amnesia subplot, which is pretty terrible for a show I like a lot. Stealth mode? There we go. Season 2 has a cougar trap, which I'll talk more about in a bit. Season 3 has an entire plot thread at the beginning that is kind of instantly forgotten on purpose. It's really terrible.
Hostile down. Move up.
Jack, it's Michelle. We have a bomb squad on their way. They're following you in.
See here.
Priming greets charge.
I copy.
So, yeah, 24's biggest failing is, of course, its format was there's 24 episodes in a season. They're an hour long. It takes place in real time.
Sir, what's going on here?
It's the ship's original crew. They must have been killed when the ship was taken over.
Up there! It's the bomb! Following your lead, sir.
Wait, where am I going? Here. Yeah, and the problem with a show like that is it's a little hard to make multiple seasons of things like happening in one day, you know? But wait, hold on. You look at the ricin bomb. So, like, season 2, they did stuff to pad it out. Season 3, they really pad it out. Then season 4 ridiculously has like 4 terrorist plots happen in a day. It's kind of crazy.
If not, I need to know right now.
I can defuse it.
What do you need from me?
Nothing. Once I set up, we'll be good to go.
CTU, O'Brien.
Chloe.
Jeez.
I've been given a job by Carr.
Do you think they're on to you?
No. No, if they were on to me, I'd be dead by now. These guys don't mess around. Whatever they're working on is something big, and I need to get to the bottom of it.
Jack? Your status.
How much longer?
I'm starting now.
Okay.
Stand by. Starting bomb defusal.
This is pretty confusing. They introduced 2 new characters here, Chloe O'Brien and Chase Edmonds, both new to season 3 of 24, which is after this video game. CTU is in LA, by the way. That's where Jack is, but Chloe and Chase are in DC. They usually don't go out of California in the show, though Mexico, I think, is in season 3, but whatever. That's a cute way, a cute thing, by the way, they do to kind of keep the weather consistent, just having it take place in California. Because, of course, the show is not filmed in real time.
It should be a case of following the master signal back through its relay paths and shorting out the trigger circuitry.
Oh. Done.
Okay, that's the first stage. Just one more.
This is a fairly easy puzzle, yeah.
That's it, I've done it.
So right now we're playing random nameless bomb defusal guy. Oh, a bonus feature, how about that?
Alpha team leader, we have defused the detonator.
Copy that. Sending in hazmat to take care of the payload.
Do you have any eyes on the arms shipments?
Negative. Nothing here but empty gun containers. Looks like the ship's already been offloaded.
Now we're going to go to terrorist base in Washington, D.C.?
Put the guns away. I said put the guns away.
Yes, sir.
Those are the blueprints you wanted. Now let's talk about where I stand in this organization.
We'll tell you where you stand, and if you don't like it, you...
I can what? I've been running errands for you for the past year and a half, and I've got nothing to show for it. Now, unless I start being cut in, I walk.
I know how doing these pissant jobs kills you. I know you want more. You're gonna get more. A buddy of ours, a guy by the name of Ricky Roberts, is gonna be pulling a small hit for us later today. He got together with a group of people, and they've proven to be pretty resourceful.
I heard Ricky Roberts moved out west.
He did. The hit's going down in L.A.
So who pissed you off so much that you've hired some surfer boy convert to kill him?
That's a terrible cliffhanger. 24 was also pretty good about ending on cliffhangers.
7 a.m. and 8 a.m.
Like, they could have just ended it on the hit is coming in L.A. Because that would bring things back over to CTU. Whatever. That's stupid.
I want this taken back to CTU for analysis right now.
Don't respond if you agree to that.
Dessler.
Michelle, I'm sending you a PDA that looks like it's encrypted. I need to know what's on it.
I'll put Sean on it as soon as it arrives.
This is too sensitive for a rookie. I want someone else on it.
I trained Sean. He can do this.
Oh, Sean.
Vice President Prescott will be in Los Angeles for the next 3 days.
Sean is completely new to the video game. He's not in seasons 2 or 3 of 24.
We got the ricin biotoxin, but the arms shipments, they're missing.
All right, we got the ricin, that's something. I'll talk to the division about following up on the missing weapons. There's nothing more we can do about it right now.
Tony, there's something else. We found the entire crew dead in one of the cargo holds. Any idea who gave CTU the tip on raiding the cargo ship?
No. All we know is that it was called in from a payphone about 4 blocks from Los Angeles Harbor. Why? What are you thinking?
That this isn't over.
CTU O'Brien.
They're planning on assassinating the vice president.
Why aren't you calling me on your cell? This line could be tapped.
No, I don't have a choice. The bunker I'm in blocks cell signals. Now listen to me. The vice president's in Los Angeles, and they're planning on having him assassinated sometime today.
When?
I don't know. You need to connect me to Los Angeles CTU.
Okay, hold on. Chase, you're on with LA CTU.
This is Tony Almeida, special agent in charge.
Agent Almeida, my name's Agent Chase Edmonds, DC CTU. Now, I've just gotten word that there'll be an assassination attempt on the vice president later today.
I need details if we're going to move forward on this.
Well, I don't have many details. All I can say is that a man by the name of Ricky Roberts is involved. He's from D.C., recently moved to Los Angeles.
Sean?
Already on it. Ricky Roberts.
Bauer.
Jack, we've gotten word from D.C. CTU. There's gonna be an assassination attempt on the vice president sometime today.
You don't know when?
No, but we have an address of someone involved. It's not far from your current position. I'm uploading his information to you right now.
Robert Daniels?
Apparently he's relatively new to L.A., but his connections stem from D.C.
I'm on my way. I'll let you know what I find.
I have Agent Edmonds.
Agent Edmonds?
What did you find out? My God, this is endless.
We found an address. We have our lead field agent checking it out now. Thanks, we'll let you know how it goes.
Take care of this.
Wait a minute, that's it? You'll let me know how it goes?
Yeah. It's in our hands now.
Chloe, are you still there? I need a flight to Los Angeles.
You can't do that. Sonia will never agree to it.
Going around, Sonia.
Chase, the phone line's being tapped.
Damn it!
You need to get out of there. I'll send a chopper.
Give me 20 minutes to lock down the base and take everyone out.
Are you crazy? You need to wait for backup.
20 minutes, Chloe.
Okay, let me... All right, there's a lot here. It's season 3 of 24. Chase Edmonds, who I'm now playing...
Chase Edmonds, this is priority one.
Who's knocking over the chair. Shut up. He's Jack's, like, partner, and he's totally new to season 3. Jack doesn't even have a partner in the first few seasons. Chloe O'Brien also works for CTU, as a computer analyst. They both work in L.A., but here in this game, they work in D.C.
Target said he's working undercover for some government agency.
What's that?
So, you ask, well, one of the things Kiefer Sutherland promised in the trailer for this game was to explain some of the things from Season 3, and one of them was, how does Chase become Jack's partner? And right now, very unrealistically, it seems like Chase is undercover, has gotten to some homeland kind of terrorist bunker, learned of a plan to assassinate the vice president in L.A., has decided to just go off on his own and just kill everyone in the base. He alerts L.A. CTU about it, and then he's going over there. And also, another thing is, this is the first time we've ever heard anything about there being, like, another CTU. Usually it's just based in L.A., but whatever. Nice ragdoll, at least. So, we're talking about the villains of it, right? So season one involves an assassination attempt against President David Palmer, who you might know as the guy from those Allstate commercials, like, it's called the Scoopin' Squad. He's got a good voice, played by Dennis Haysbert. Everybody likes President Palmer. Oops. Nice. I don't know why they're giving me a split screen here. NY CTUs in season 8. See, I don't like that. I like there being like one CTU, but whatever, I guess. Let's see. So basically what happens is season one's very localized. They kidnap Jack's family, and it's basically like, you are going to carry out the assassination on David Palmer, or else we're going to kill your family kind of deal. And this also introduces Alicia Cuthbert, who plays Jack's daughter, Kim Bauer, and we're going to see her later. And that's... Kim Bauer is a whole nother can of worms on this show. But one of the things I really did like about 24 is that season 1 took place in 2001, and one of the plot threads involved the plane that was destroyed in midair by terrorists. Like, passengers got killed and everything. Okay. That was kind of bullshit, I think. He wasn't president yet in season... You're right, I'm sorry. He's a presidential candidate in season 1, and in season 2, he's the president. You're right, sorry about that. Thank you, Tentoir. Anyway, where was I? Right. So anyway, the September 11th attacks happened then, and Fox, you know, out of sort of respect and all that, like, oh, I'm all the way back here, decides to, like, kind of put the show on hiatus, more or less, you know, which I think is fair. So they put the show off for a couple of weeks. It came back. The show... And then season 2, which is a year later, is about Islamic terrorists sneaking a nuke into Los Angeles and trying to detonate it that day. And it's handled with more care than you might think it is. They do a lot of, they go into like sort of ethical quandaries and stuff where like Jack has the decision to kill like a terrorist family. You know what I mean? There's like, and what... It is interesting is that even though he has, like, these sort of things where he's, like, almost kind of torturing... Well, actually, he doesn't, I don't think, in that one. But, like, he's threatening the terrorists and doing all these sort of... He has, like, these sort of ethical dilemmas or whatever, but there are comeuppance for them. Typically, people cite 24 when they say, like, a show that glamorizes torture. I don't really think that came into play until season... I don't know why the camera... Season 4, I think, did that specifically, to be honest. That's all I really want to say about it. But I do think the show kinda... I can't say it gets a bad rap, but whatever. That's all I wanted to mention about that. It's, yeah. What was the other thing I was going to say about that? Yeah, George Mason was pretty awesome, too. Whoops. Season 2 happens. In season 3, Jack's a heroin junkie, just kind of out of nowhere. We're never gonna learn how he becomes it. It's mentioned in season 3 that he was going undercover and decided to do heroin to blend in, and he's a junkie. Basically, he kind of handles that pretty well in season 3, and it never comes up again. He just quits because he's Jack Bauer, and he's a tough guy, I guess. Anyway, yeah, season 4, it's back to Islamic terrorists, and they really have a lot of trouble making it like a 24-hour thing, so there's like 4 plots going off at once, like, oh, they're gonna set off a dirty bomb, and then, you know, the terrorists are gonna set off a dirty bomb, but then that doesn't work, so then they're gonna, like, hijack some other nuclear weapons and blah, blah, blah. Season 5 was brought... I forgot about this. Whoa. Season 5 is actually really good. It does involve, like, the Russians and, like, the president's kind of... The new president's kind of in on things. It's really... I do like season 5 now that I think about it. This is a pretty boring and weird level. Where, again, 24 is usually not, like, a Rambo type of action-y thing. But the game... This game really is... Yeah, exactly. The terrorist has, like, 5 contingency plans. Here. What season does Doc Brown steal plutonium from the Libyans?
Ooh. Hey!
Hey. Ooh. I mean, I think he could have killed me with that shotgun, but I'll take it. What else do we want to talk about, 24? Now, if you notice, too, what technically happened here was Chase broke protocol. All right, I'm pressing X there. You know, and that's how he got caught. And now he's just going to kill everyone and then figure out he's going above his boss's head, which is something that, like, in government, like, agencies, they love for you to do. Is like go out of like jurisdiction and rules, you know. After season 3, I'm being told Jack technically doesn't work for CTU anymore. Technically, in season 2, he did not work for CTU either. What happens is they find out the nuke is going to go off that day. The only person with any sort of like possible like. That they could plant as an undercover person is Jack, because the Islamic terrorists are working with like a domestic terrorist group that kind of knows something about it. Yeah, it's like, for all the shit it gets, it is, I think, a fun show. And I would recommend the first 2 seasons at least.
20 minutes.
Thanks for hosting, Matt. Alright, so we stopped the breach. I just quit heroin yesterday, it's easy. To be totally fair, in season 3, they give him, I guess it's supposed to be methadone, but they give him like a pill halfway through. To like, his withdrawal is actually kind of a thing in the first half of the season, but then, aka the first half of the day, but then he kind of like gets over it. It is a little fucked up. There we go. Every season has someone at CTU turn out to be evil. That's true too. That is actually true. We couldn't do this last time because I was having issues with the controller, but let's drive this truck or Jeep. All right, vehicle shit.
I've been looking forward to this, Chase.
Woo. So, it's boss time. We have to kill car and target.
Over there. Come on!
Whoa, turn.
You bastard!
Alright, one down. I really don't know why you can, like, why enemies can surrender, like, what that does. Doesn't methadone last a day? It does, but, like, I don't think you can, I mean, I don't know, actually, at all, so I could be wrong on this. I don't think you can, like, just take methadone and you're just, like, fine. You know, it's just like, yeah, okay, I'm ready to face the day or whatever. I don't know. I could be wrong. I probably am wrong. Because then I think people, too, like, they get addicted to the methadone. Is that part of it, also? I don't really know too much about heroin, sadly.
Hey!
Oops. Jerk.
I'm hit!
I'm hit. Oh, it depends on the dosage, apparently. Wait, no, okay. Hey, what?
Take this!
Sort of Sentinel says methadone's highly addicted. I don't know if what they give him is methadone, but at any rate, yeah. Jack's just whatever about it, and especially seasons 4, 5, 6, etc. The heroine just never comes up again. I remember because seasons 1 and 2 were like so good, I recommended it to my, like, my friends, my brother and one of my friends started watching it, and they're like, wow, this show's great, and, like, the whole time with season three, I'm like, yeah, it's okay now. It's good, but not, you know. It's no season one and two.
It was not...
This controls could be a lot better, I just want to say. Whatever. At least Chase is looking a little smug. Season 3 took a while to pick up. Yeah, season 3 is kind of... The biggest issue with season 3 is, yeah, it takes a while to pick up, and the whole, like, there's a part where they have, like, a first half of the season where it's like, oh, some of the stuff that's happening doesn't have any real consequence to it because there's a bit of a trick going... Basically...
Just doing my job.
All right. There's a part where they're more or less... How do I put this? All right. There's supposed to be like a biological weapon that this kid has gotten in a drug trade. He's like being a drug mule for money, but he doesn't... He thinks he has cocaine, but he really has like some kind of like biological weapon... Pretty tense and awesome, but then it turns out the thing he's got is actually harmless, which is like, oh, that's stupid, you know? Oh dear.
Hey!
Yeah, take cover, Chase. So what happens is like the whole like first half of the season turns out that all the tension it had was not very tense, you know? If that makes sense. It was just kind of you know. Yeah, so that was like one of my least favorite like things that 24 pulled off. There we go. I have 45 seconds to do something. Exit the base. Uh-oh. Okay, 36 seconds to exit the base. Why is that timed? Why do I have so little time to exit this base? Where is the fucking exit? I'm gonna lose this, aren't I? Yeah, that's... Hey! Yeah. So remember when I said, there's always something wrong with a season of 24? In season 3's case, it's like the entire first half is, like, a big, like, just kidding kind of deal. Had Ryan Chappelle in it. Who the hell is Ryan Chappelle? This is such bullshit. I'm gonna run out of time on this thing. Deactivated. Wow! 1 second! That was quite the 24 thing in it. Who was the villain of season 3? Villain of season 3 was... There were these two Mexican brothers. They were like drug lords. I can't think of their names. At any rate, Chase has left the base. Here's the helicopter from DCCTU with all his backup, I guess. Oh yeah, I remember Ryan Chappelle now, right? Again, a pretty bad cliffhanger for 24.
Following takes place between 8 a.m. and 9 a.m.
Bauer.
Jack, we haven't been able to find
anyone. That wasn't the right subtitle.
So we don't have any idea when he might be leaving the address you have. We're worried he's going to take off soon. How close are you?
I'm almost there.
You need to hurry. He's the only lead we have right now.
I'll be there.
Who? Oh, this guy that maybe Chase called in. I think... Whoa, what? Alright, so, yes, driving. Again, 24 came around, like...
Out.
Why should I watch out? I'm not... Alright, whatever. 24 came out around the time Grand Theft Auto was out, so they tried to make it kind of open-worldy, but the linear format of the show makes that kind of impossible. You might notice a lot of the cars are seemingly, like... Or those buses are just sort of jumping, and... Yeah, this part of the game is not great. T- No, Delectropy, you're out of your mind. One, two is, well, I like, all right. Five is definitely below one and two. That's crazy talk. Get out of here. That person's inside the whatever. Okay, I guess I'm going to this thing.
Michelle, it's Jack. I'm at Daniel's house. It looks clear. I'm going in. Son of a bitch. Michelle, he's our only lead. Without him, we don't know what the threat is. I can't afford to let him get away.
Michelle doesn't know what you're talking about, Jack. You're on a cell phone. This 24 used to be one of my favorite shows. I just think season 6 really hurt it, in my opinion. I think it's terrible. All right, then.
Hey, watch out!
Five had Keeler. Was Keeler the RoboCop guy? Five really was good, don't get me wrong. And I forgot how good it was until somebody reminded me of the whole Logan subplot and Marty and all that stuff. That was really well done. That was like the president's in on shit, and then like the first lady gets involved in it, and she's like a really, really good character. It's like, just really, yeah. Get out of my way, please. So, yeah, this plays like a fairly cheap ETA clone in the overworld. If I wanted to, wait, why? Don't give me a fucking split screen right now. Okay, that was obnoxious. Like, I know that's the show's signature, but that was dick. Okay. Yeah, usually 24 is a little, I can't say it's grounded in reality, but like, this is just kind of like, okay, got ricin, now there's going to be a vice presidential assassination, now let's kill everybody in the base, now you're, I guess this is a car chase, I don't know. Stop that!
Take him out!
Whoa. Alright, I don't know how I would see in real life with the fucking hood up like that, but we'll just keep going, I guess.
Come on, get him!
Who's talking right now? I thought Jack was alone in the car. I can't... Whoa, what the f... There's a nice skyline, I guess. So, I guess the van is shooting other cars?
Watch out!
I don't really know what I'm supposed to be doing here. Oh, shit. One of the things you can do in the game is commandeer vehicles, you know. I was doing that. Alright, I guess I did good. Season 1 was basically split into two halves. That's true, Eva Tussle. I do think it was like...
Thank you, Mr. Edmonds. Your flight will be taking off in about an hour.
So, yeah, Chase Edmonds decides to defy all orders and protocol and just fly himself out to L.A. to meet with, like, CTU people he's never met or talked to or anything to continue the leads or whatever. Yes,
sir. Michelle, it's Jack. Robert Daniels just entered an office building located at 1023 North Bronson. I need the floor plans of the building as soon as I can get them.
1023 North Bronson is right in the heart of the financial district. What's Daniels doing there?
I don't know, but I need to find out before he gets to where he's going.
Why? We don't know what he's doing. Wait. All right, well. Mission accomplished? Oh.
Jack, we got building schematics. I'm uploading them now.
Okay, thanks, Michelle.
That was, like, I needed to press a button for that. Oh, oops. So wherever Jack was going... Wherever Jack was going... What am I trying to say here? I guess has, like, a bunch of people shooting at him?
It's damaged.
Sorry. It's damaged. So yeah, see, you can take control of any vehicle you'd like in the game. You can commandeer vehicles. Yeah, it works. You already knew that part, game. We did that before. Thank you.
What are you doing here?
This guy just goes, what are you doing here? And starts shooting at us. Oh, what are you...
I'm hit! Who are you?
Who am I? Why would you just shoot me? What is the best season? I say two.
Rodriguez here. I'm heading to the loading bay now. I'll be back up in the lobby soon.
Okay, don't take too long.
But generally, I think one is typically the one.
Who are you?
Intruder!
Is Daniels here yet? I'm heading up to the top floor now. I'm gonna want a status update when I get there.
I feel like there's the cast of 24 doing their acting stuff, and then just random people they found around the studio. All right. I don't know why hitting this guy is not working, but
Rodriguez,
what the fuck?
Come in, Rodriguez.
Jesus. I need to heal up somehow. Jesus, camera, fuck.
What are you doing here?
Oh.
Who are you?
This is ridiculous.
I'm hit.
What are you doing here?
So this is actually the soundtrack from the show, by the way. I'm not joking about that. Yeah.
Who are you?
Is that guy wearing a short sleeve button down? Oh no, I thought that was a tie.
I surrender.
I just shot you 4 times.
Eat this! Doing here?
Why would you ask me that after you start shooting? Yeah, I don't know, like, why we're in, like, an enemy base or something, but... Wait, what? Okay.
Michelle, the door's got security swipe card protection. I need to bypass it.
If it's a simple configuration, you'll see the swipe card's data number appearing in the top panel. You'll need to unscramble the data below to match
right,
that
Z is the second one, right? Right, V. First one? No. It, V. Okay, just, let's get back to Z. Right, J is the third one. Yep. X was the fourth. Yay. We did it, I guess. What are you doing here? Everyone is just so, like, lackadaisical about shit. Hold on, wait.
What are you doing here?
There we go. Alright, what else can we talk about with 24? Was that me? Ow.
Take this!
Here. I don't know why Jack can't kick them while they're down like Chase could, but whatever.
I'm hit!
Jesus, okay, fine. Anyway. Shotgun shot.
Go to hell.
Take cover!
Huh?
Who are you?
Why is there a computer desk, like, at the top of stairs?
Who are you?
Like that needs to be a highlight.
We're at the second floor admin area now, starting the search for the intruder. Let's go. Spread out, guys.
So, yeah, I don't know. Really go for some health, but.
Who are you?
Eat this.
What?
Take this.
Take what? Oh, come on, I had a shotgun and it went around that guy's head. Whatever. The multi-camera thing worked a lot better on the show, I just want to say.
Bluebird, what's going on?
Bluebird? What terrible terrorists are these? Boss, we're on him. Alright.
Who are you?
Ah! 24 board game? No, I never played the 24 board game, but I did play the mobile game. Which was not like a smartphone game. But my favorite thing about it was you could like enter your own name. Chloe O'Brien, who is that computer person, told me, like, it was an honor working with you, Agent Slowbeef, or whatever. Like, it was funny. Like, the characters from the show would, like, talk to you. It was my dream come true. Bird is a code name for Team Mystic. Sons of bitches. So I guess we're in, like, an unfinished office building that... Huh? What hurt? Did something hurt me there? Well, yeah. Jeez. All right. The yellow arrow says go left. Oh.
What are you doing here?
Why would? Don't shoot the paint cans, Jack. Oh.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I should say one thing, because I know I've played this game before. I know where this story's going. The show was not as bad as where the story goes in this game. Just want to say that. Uh-oh.
Come any closer and I shoot!
Yay! Huh? What? Wait, what the hell is this? Why?
Who are you?
Huh? Who are you, lady? Adrenaline? What does adrenaline do?
What are you doing here?
Oh, that's temporary invincibility. Sounded like he ejaculated more than anything. Well, that's not temporary invincibility. That's just extra health, I think, like super armor.
Hit.
Jack, shoot the f- All right, whatever. Wait, what? Oh, did I break his neck? I like to think the who are you questions are rhetorical, like, who does Jack Bauer think he is? I'm answering the phone.
Jack, we know why Daniels is at that address. It's on the Vice President's motorcade route.
You need to call Secret Service and have them change the route.
Let go of the phone, Jack!
The communication signals. Working on it, but it's going to take more time than we have.
Sorry, no, Michelle, you're going to have to repeat that.
Robert Daniels before Vice President Prescott reaches your location.
We really just can't tell the Secret Service, like, that this is going to happen, and they should... Alright, whatever. Gotta let it ring a couple times so she doesn't know. So she doesn't know you were busy.
Eat this!
This is like the third time you've told me that, 24 the game. I know how to clamber on objects. God, how many fucking people did they bring to assassinate the goddamn Vice President?
What's your status, O'Neill?
Ambush set. On fifth floor, just left of the elevator.
Good. Don't let him pass. We can't afford any mistakes.
See? I feel like the person who's doing this is like 16 or something. Hear his voice? Alright, S must be the first one. C. Oh, nice. That was easy. Everyone sounds really tired when they die. I agree. Okay, let's clamber onto objects like we know how to do. Take the stupid shotgun. There's two guys here. Which...
Who are you?
Oh. Not fair.
Who are you?
What are you doing?
I'm hit.
Oh. Wait, what?
I have to take him alive.
Oh, I do? Why? Who? Shoot to injure, I think that said. Alright then. This is very annoying.
Take cover!
There's nowhere to run, Daniels!
Hey, get, fucking split screen. Uh-oh.
Who are you?
Huh? Damn it. Where they start me? Each day end with Jack Bauer. See, I always thought it would be good if he was tell someone like this. Today is like, whoo, crazy. That's my 24 wish. Ah, sorry. Now some of you, I'm sure, are saying, why don't you take cover and do all this? Nothing.
What are you doing?
What are you doing here?
Daniels! It's over.
There. All right.
God, you bastard! You shot me.
I want answers, and I want them now.
Okay.
I didn't shoot him though. Again, a shit cliffhanger.
The following takes place between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m.
Okay. So here, now we're gonna interrogate someone on 24. This is the stress graph. Only when in the stress level is in the cooperation zone, so you can aggressive, coaxing, and calming. Got it. Reach into my neck.
Tell me what the plan is.
I won't tell you anything.
I know about you, Robert. Where you've been, what you've done, so please don't assault me. Just tell me what I need to know.
Not calming.
Oh, you know nothing.
I want answers. What's the assassination plan?
You shot me. I need a doctor.
Please talk to me.
And you have no proof of nothing.
Tell me about the plot against the vice president.
You think I'm gonna talk?
I'm just alternating between angry and calm.
I want to help you out here, but you gotta start talking.
Even if I knew something, I wouldn't talk.
I need to know about the plan against the vice president. Tell me what it is. You need to tell me about the plot against the vice president.
I'm telling you nothing.
The cokes.
Now come on.
I'm not the guy you're looking for.
Just tell me the plan.
You've got nothing on me.
The only way out of here is for you to talk.
I won't talk.
You have no idea how far I'm willing to go to get these answers.
It's nothing to do with me. You got the wrong guy.
Tell me what the plan is.
I have nothing to say to you.
The scumbags you work for in DC gave you up.
Nothing. You've got nothing.
Please tell me what I want to know and I can protect you.
You'll get nothing out of me.
You say I got nothing. Conspiracy to murder the acting president. Is that what you call nothing? Now talk to me.
It's too late. There's nothing you can do to stop it.
If you talk, I can help you get out of here.
I'm telling you nothing.
Why are you looking out the window? What's out there? Snipers. Are they on the rooftops? Is that it?
It's too late. There are too many of them for you to stop.
I can't help you unless you work with me.
It's too late for you to do anything.
Tell me about the snipers. Answer me.
How do we even know they're snipers?
I don't have to do what you say.
While you're here with me, yes, you do.
There's too many. You can't stop
them. How is this working?
Start talking now!
You'll never take them all out.
Please, you need to give me information on the snipers.
Never! I'll never tell you!
You don't know what I'm capable of.
It's too late.
Give me some answers, Robert, and I can protect you.
It's too late for you to do anything.
Talk to me.
There's too many. You can't stop them.
I know what you're supposed to do, yeah.
Tell me their locations.
You'll never find them.
Give me some answers, Robert, and I can protect you.
There's no time.
Come on, Robert, this is important. How many snipers are there?
Hey!
Seven. There are seven.
Well, you told me what I wanted to know, I think. All right, I guess let's try that. All right. So to be fair, no, because someone's saying, like, they didn't put torture. Jack didn't do a lot of torture, really. That was, like, again, season four, where he started to, like... Well, It's not a show where he does, like, terrible things to people. It was usually stuff like this. I shouldn't say that. I'm saying this wrong, but it's not what you think it is. Whatever. That's all my only point.
I want answers. What's the assassination plan?
You shot me! I need a doctor!
Let's see.
You know what the plan is.
It's nothing to do with
it. It's not very coaxing. I'm gonna do it the right way now.
You got the wrong guy.
I know who you are, Robert. Your friends turned on you.
Nothing. You've got nothing!
Talk and we might be able to cut a deal.
It's too late. There's nothing you can do to stop it.
Oh, see there. He did look out the window.
Snipers, they're on the rooftops.
Again, that's not coaxing.
There are too many of them.
I don't think it is. Calm him down, I guess.
I can't help you unless you work with me.
There's nothing you can do.
Tell me about the snipers, Robert.
I don't have to answer you.
While you're here with me, yes, you do.
I'm telling you nothing.
Come on, Robert, this is important. How many snipers are there?
I don't see how he's convincing him of any of this stuff, though.
Seven. There are seven.
Yeah, I was doing it wrong on purpose last time. I just wanted to all be a jerk.
I'm not sure. All I know is that they're positioned on rooftops all along the Vice President's motorcade route in this part of town.
That's... well, we could have figured that out.
Start talking now!
He is talking, Jack.
You'll never find them.
Now give me the location on the snipers.
He just said.
I'm not afraid of you.
He said they're on the rooftop on the...
I'm capable of.
It's too late.
I need to find the snipers, Robert. How do I do that?
The roof. They're visible from the roof.
We knew that.
You can't access it. The door is electronically locked.
Oh my god.
Is there a code?
You do need a code, but I don't have any idea what it is, I swear.
I need answers, and I need them now.
There's too many. You can't stop them.
I'd hit circle to win it.
This is your last chance. I want the code. Give it to me now.
It's 603-1968. I swear that's the code. 603-1968.
Oh, 90%. What do you know? Bonus feature, even. Eesh. This is literally the worst thing to happen to video games.
You realize it's not gonna matter.
Yeah, it looks a little better in the cutscene.
Dessler.
Michelle, Daniels told me that there's 7 snipers positioned around the Vice President's motorcade route. Have you gotten through to Secret Service?
No, the signal's still jammed.
That's what I was afraid of. I'm gonna have to take out each sniper individually.
You have their positions?
No, all what? I know is that they're in buildings waiting for the motorcade to pass.
I'll have Sean see if he can locate them using SatNav-1.
Call me when you've got something.
Sean.
Yeah, the show isn't like this.
Vidlink?
Everything I've done has been with simulations, just training exercises. I've never...
That's good
oh,
enough.
Sean.
You need to sign on using HMC protocol. There's not much time.
Oh, it looks like we're playing as Sean now. Alright, 5 buildings marked on the map. Thermal imaging. Hold X over heat sources.
Sean, you're going to need to check the buildings in Jack's area. Make sure you scan all the floors. They could be anywhere with a clear vantage point.
That one? That's I am doing that. That's a sniper. I really have to check all the friggin'. This is not a clear vantage point anyway. Maybe I'm supposed to. This is a clear vantage point, I think. Uh-oh, 2 snipers found. Seems like it could be one. Yeah, you know, 3. This is one, definitely, I think. He said they were on the rooftop, said Cycle-inspired Metalsmith. Well, I guess he was wrong. Oh, wait, it would be along the top. You're right, yeah, that's not a good place. This would be, like, a good vantage point. It says targets found out of 9. But I thought there were 7 snipers. Look at that in the lower right. What? One sniper for each of the deadly sins. Six out of 9. Nice. Be along the left, I think. This guy, like, this has to be a sniper, right? So then this thing, I guess, is another building, so maybe along the right side there'd be
Jack's
a sniper.
Need the data soon. Have you found the potential targets yet?
There's like 9 of them, Michelle. One enemy. And for bottom here. Along the top that I missed. Along the top or the right that I missed, maybe.
Jack needs the target information. You've only got 1 minute before we upload the data.
Found 8 of them, and he only needed 7, Michelle. I think that's pretty good. This guy could be one, actually. How about this? Here, this guy. Oh, man. Alright, I'll just analyze this guy. I don't think this is right. On the right side. Left side, I guess. Stupid. This wouldn't be one. Oops. Uh-oh. What about Jack's building? Now you can't examine
it. Not bad, but you didn't thoroughly search all the buildings.
I did, though.
You got. I'll take over and do a final search.
Oh. Thanks, Michelle. Michelle Dessler is a character on the show. She came in season 2. Pretty regular. I like her.
We need to upload this to Jack's GPS immediately.
I'm on it.
Yeah.
They have a good romance subplot, Michelle and Tony, in season 2, by the way. Tony Almeida.
Got it.
Legitimately good. I don't know where we got a sniper rifle, but whatever.
We've located some potential targets. There wasn't time to do a complete search. I'll let you know if we find anything else.
Damn it, Michelle, I need all the locations. Tell me when you've got them.
Alright, no. So, right stick is move, and left stick is zoom, which is the opposite of what I would have done, but... Controls are really...
Found new targets for you. Uploading now.
There were 7 snipers, right? Okay. I also can't steady Jack's aim, which is annoying. What is... That's 3, right? Hey, fuck. I get him or no? Yeah, that got him. Very annoying. They're all dressed the same, the snipers, too. Uh-oh. I think this is good enough, to be honest. I mean...
Michelle, the motorcade has been attacked.
Jack, you've got to keep the vice president and his people safe. Take out those snipers.
I did.
Jack, I'm uploading more target information.
What? How many snipers are there? This is way more than 7 or 9, I think. Well, not, I don't know how many. So annoying. It's like hard as shit to control any of it. I'm sorry, like it's like waving all around. Like I can't. Alright, I'm not moving right now at all.
Jack, what's the status on the snipers? You need to take them out as quickly as possible.
Sorry, Michelle. Geez, very easy to do shit when you're on a fucking computer all day. Sorry.
That's it. All targets have been taken out, Michelle. I repeat, all targets have been neutralized.
I'm sure she got it. This is garbage.
Our flight time to Los Angeles will be approximately 5 hours.
And he flew coach, Chase. So ridiculous.
Almeida.
I need medics here right now. We've got people down.
It should only be another couple of minutes.
Some of these people might not have a couple of minutes.
What are you talking about?
Sir, get back.
Is that the vice president? Why are there no, like,
sir,
Secret Service?
My name is Agent Jack Bauer. I'm with Los Angeles CTU. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Good. That's good. You need to stay awake, sir. Keep your eyes
interrogate him, Jack.
Hospital as quickly as I can.
You have no idea what I'm capable of. No!
Dessler. Yes.
Oh, here we go.
No, that's my fault. Send her in.
What's going on?
We have an intern starting today. With everything that's been going on, I completely
forgot. Yes, who the intern is.
There's no way we can have an intern starting today. There's too much going on.
Our new intern is Kim Bauer.
That's Jack's daughter, Kim Bauer. Well, thank you, game.
Where do you want me?
Look, Kim, this isn't the best day for you to start.
Oh, okay.
Kim Bauer, right?
Hey, yes. Sean.
Great. Glad you're here. Sean Walker. Follow me to the tech room. I'll get you started.
Okay. Season 3, Kim is working for CTU. In Season 2, she's just a civilian. Jack, apparently between season, gets her an associate's degree in computer science, really, and she is an intern. She's... Nah. Well, who the hell is this now?
The following takes place between 10 a.m. and 11 a.m.
Hell of a morning.
Dessler.
Michelle, Daniels has taken off in a stolen car from the assassination site. I'm trailing him onto the freeway. I'll let you know where he leads
Wasn't
me.
Wasn't that the guy I interrogated?
That was Jack. He's shadowing Robert Daniels. Thinks he'll lead him somewhere.
Until Sean decrypts that PDA, Daniels is the only lead we've got.
Do you want me to pull Sean off the decryption and take over?
No, not yet.
I've gotten through the blanket encrypt, but it looks like the data was scrambled when the initial encryption took place. We won't know anything until I repair the damaged files and download them to my system.
How long will that take?
It shouldn't take... Wait a second. Oh, no.
What's going on?
There must have been a fail-safe mechanism. I need to get the information off this thing in less than 7 minutes, or it'll lock down and be impossible to decipher.
Oh, man. More computer stuff. PDA decrypt. A cube is highlighted. Blue cubes, X, or red cubes to repair the file. Oh, I'm not okay, so this is that yellow ring randomly goes around a chip, and I have to press X on the blue and circle on the red, I guess? But really, all there is to this? So for the record, too, because I saw somebody mention in chat, and I'm not saying it's unrealistic that Jack would use nepotism to get his daughter a job at CTU. I am saying that for, like, the kind of work that they're allegedly doing here, like, you know, cryptography and all that, I mean, you need more than 0 years experience in the field and all that. And Kim Bauer is not especially technical. Oh, this is getting a little faster. Again, I know it's not, like, the most realistic show, and who cares, but still. I thought they were gonna make me start over again. Whew.
Okay, I've recovered the files. Now I just need to bypass the file encryption.
F. R was the second one, right?
Hmm.
W was the third one. R was the... Done. Next level. Ay. Can I try to get F then? H. B with it. I'm just using, like, I'm just trying to alphabetically sort them. Actually, F would have been next. Shit. All right. A. So let's see if P is that one. Z is that. That's gotta be Z. Done. Yay. Done.
That's all I was able to get. The crew manifest, I understand.
87% good.
Run a cross-reference on the list of dead crewmen that were found on the cargo ship and this new crew manifest.
Yes, sir.
Lee Jin Yu.
His is the only name that's not on both lists. He's on the crew manifest, but wasn't on the cargo ship.
Well, we need to find him. Now.
That 297 results and he did it that quick? Tony, I mean, by eyeballing it? Why didn't we arrest
this guy?
My
fellow Americans, 6 months ago, individuals acting against the United States government attempted to remove me from office through assassination.
Okay, so...
Another group of individuals tried to take the life of President Prescott. Their attempts failed as well, but his condition at this time is critical.
Yeah.
I've reconfirmed that the on-record address we're able to find for Lee Jin Yu is obsolete.
So you think the paper trail to this liquor store is our best bet?
Okay.
He has had 3 credit card transactions there in the past week, not to mention the weeks prior. The owner of the place is a Mr. Shin.
Hold on. Let me just explain something real quick. Season 1 of 24 had a great final ending, right? Like a little twist kind of deal. Season 2, they wanted to do the same thing, but they kind of couldn't because all the plot threads hadn't wrapped up. So out of fucking nowhere in the last hour, they throw a big assassination attempt thing at President Palmer. This character from the first season, who they never resolved, comes back out of nowhere, shakes his hand, turns out she has a biological weapon on her hand, his hand is all fucked up, and he collapses, and that's the end of Season 2. And now that's what he's talking about, the assassination attempt. It was totally stupid, out of left field, and he's completely fine in Season 3. So you're kind of like, what the hell happened? And the game was supposed to explain it, but they don't.
He should know him.
Let's hope so.
Anyway. Oh, so now I'm Tony Almeida, who's... What the hell is wrong with you, buddy? Okay. R2 to talk?
I'm with CTU. I'm looking for this man. Have you seen him?
You know...
Sorry, sir. I don't know him.
Well, I... Wait, what?
You're lying. Tell me what you know about him.
I'm not lying. I not know him.
Look. Stop messing with me and tell me what you know.
Please, believe me. I'm not lying to you.
This guy thinks I'm like no one, right? But
look, I know he's been in this shop several times in the last 2 weeks.
Sorry, I am new. I have not seen him.
Who developed this game?
I think you're lying. Tell me about this man, now.
I have the box here.
Please, believe me.
2K games, actually.
I'm not lying to you.
How long have you worked here?
Only a few days. I'm new.
Okay. Tell me who else can help me.
Mr. Shin. You need to talk to Mr. Shin.
I'm not interested in Mr. Shin. Tell me about the man I'm looking for.
I don't know anything. Nothing to say.
No, Mr. Shin. Who is he?
Who's he?
Don't want to get him in trouble.
Is Mr. Shin the owner?
Yes, he's not in trouble.
What the hell camera angle is this?
I don't want to get him in trouble.
How did you meet Mr. Shin?
How did you meet Mr. Shin?
Met him when I applied for a job here.
I love asking all these stupid questions.
Do you know where Mr. Shin lives?
No. I just work here.
I need to know where Mr. Shin is. It's very important. A man's life is at stake.
Mr. Shin is in back rooms, I think. Customers not allowed in.
Oh my god.
Are you stalling me for a reason? What are you up to?
Nothing. Not up to anything. Don't shout!
Kick him out! You don't know who he is.
What is Mr. Shin doing in the back rooms?
I don't know. Maybe stock taking?
Guy is so patient with me.
Let me into the back room. I need to talk to Mr. Shin right now.
Okay. I'll let you in. Just don't get me in trouble.
Thank you, by the way. I'll take a pack of cigarettes while we're here in a six-pack. I just sell wine. Camera is so bad.
Where is he?
You lied to me, cashier.
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk.
Go away!
Where is he? Oh, it's pointing me back in. Wait. Why is... Wait, I don't understand. Why is the yellow dot just, like, there?
Michelle, it's Tony. I lost him.
Aw. Don't tell HR, but he is dating Tony. He is dating Michelle Vessler. I will say 24, the first couple seasons, handles, like, romance subplots pretty well, believe it or not. Like, because it's in a day, so it's not like two people meet and they're just making out or whatever. Like, that's handled...
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk.
It's stupid, but it really is kind of like, okay, the way they do that.
Go away!
Come on, Mr. Shin. Whoa, what? Why is there a guard table out here? What the fuck? Mr. Shin, how are you so strong? Look how big these fucking... This is so ridiculous. Thank God for my radar. If any of them in this game had, like, backup or something, this would probably be a lot easier for everyone. Was this segment developed by the creators of Looney Tunes? I don't know, it's just...
Mr. Shin, stop!
What? Wait, I'm sorry, what? What? How did I fail that? I was totally blocked on a fucking invisible wall. What the fuck? Oh.
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk.
That's such bullshit.
Go away.
Oh my god, what a bunch of crap that was. No.
Michelle, it's Tony. I lost him.
Destructible cat, can you save that highlight for me to see later?
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk.
I love that there's, like, no sound effects or anything.
Go away!
No, wait, Tony. Oh, okay, well. I can't believe I didn't lose him after all that. Oh my god. I don't know what this leap is supposed to do, but... No way! I want to know why he's, like, running from me, though. I don't think that's helping me catch up to him. I knew it! I only...
Mr. Shin,
I totally caught him! Did I not fucking catch him? What am I supposed to fucking do here? One more time.
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk.
God damn it, Tony.
Go away!
They do. I feel like the dive doesn't really help me. Ah, shit. I'm wrong. Like, you gain a little with the dive, but then you lose it once he, like, stops. I feel like just running straight, like, you run a little faster than he does.
Stop! You're not in trouble!
That's new. That's new, right? Stop, you're not in trouble thing? Oh no!
Mr. Shin, stop!
Come on! Let's try one more time. Who moved that ladder? Seriously. Alright. Let me just... No, he's gonna run right.
Mr. Shin, I just wanna talk!
Go away!
He's gonna fucking be running for no goddamn reason, too, I know it. Christ, I don't think I'm gonna catch him. I don't see what else I could be doing quite right. Oh, all right, that dumpster fucked me.
Michelle, it's Tony. I lost him.
Alright. Anybody check game facts or something? I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong at all. Holding X to sprint, yeah, I mean...
Mr. Shin, I just want to talk!
The problem that I'm having, though, is like... Like, it's hard to run as Tony. Thanks, Admiral Four. Gotta remember, most of the dumpsters just change sides. about that one, though. That's the one that usually trips me up. LDR shoot him twice.
CTU! Federal agent!
Oh.
CTU! Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent! CTU!
How did he make the barrel?
Federal agent! CTU!
There! Whatever. I forgot about the yell button. I should be using that more. My apologies.
Mr. Shin, there's nowhere for you to go.
I
need you to cooperate. Answer a few questions.
One handcuff is fine.
Some will say I'm in no condition to return to office.
Seem fine.
I say my health is in optimum condition. I say I have never been stronger.
What?
I, who have a sworn duty to lead this country in times of peace and in times of war, shall retake my place at the head of government.
That's the cliffhanger?
The following takes place between 11 a.m. and 12 p.m.
And we are off the air, Mr. President. You did well.
I wish I thought so, Kevin.
You sounded like your old self.
See? The assassination attempt left him wheelchair bound, but he walks in season 3, so whatever.
Stronger every day. It's just a matter of time.
And that Secret Service guy with him is in the season 3 too.
They don't give me pep talks like this.
My job is to make you well, sir. That includes helping you in any way I can.
Thank you, Kevin.
Get some rest, sir.
Sorry.
This is Michelle.
I've got Jinyu's current address. It's not that far from here. I'm on my way there right now.
What?
What's the address? I'll send backup to meet you.
8025 Orion.
It may take a team a little while to arrive.
That's fine. Have them meet me when they get there. I'll keep you updated.
Okay.
All right. Some of you saying, how? Commandeer your vehicles is how. See, it's like Grand Theft Auto. You can just take whatever vehicle you want and drive it for a very short period to a waypoint before doing a mini mission, like a little mission or whatever. 24, the game isn't very good in that regard. Later, some of the driving sections are, like, there's one driving thing in particular that is, like, I guess I'll put it this way, nonsense. There is one other thing I should tell you about Season 2 and the Palmer assassination attempt, too, is so... The whole thing with Season 2 is there's a nuclear device set off to go in Los Angeles, right? And it's this Middle Eastern country, or no, Islamic terrorist. But what happens is they're actually funded by these like oil industrialists. And the idea is they're trying to frame three Middle Eastern nations to make us go to war with them so that they can get the oil, basically. So... Yes, it's Islam a terrorist, but it's really, like, the oil industry, the evil oil industry behind it, right, in Season 2. So, basically, once both plots are foiled, vis-a-vis the nuke is, you know, neutralized, and the plot is uncovered and all that, they just go to this random guy on a yacht. We've never seen him before, he's just some German guy, and they're like, okay, let's try Plan B, and that's when, out of nowhere, there's just this assassination attempt on the president, which leads to the things I described before. It's totally weird and out of nowhere. We're gonna find what happened to those folks on the yacht in the video game, because they're never ever mentioned again on the show, or the one guy on the yacht, I should say. I think his name is Max. That mission was just driving. I don't know how I could have gotten less than 100% on it, but Almeida.
Have you arrived at Yu's apartment yet?
I just got here.
I managed to find his apartment number for you.
That was 8025.
628.
All right, thanks.
I thought there was a team meeting me here. Poison handshake. Yeah, that's how. So one of the terrorists in season one is a woman named Mandy. Yeah. So Mandy.
Hey man, you got my stuff?
I got it. You got the cash?
Yeah, here it is. I'm doing you a favor.
Put down your
you
weapon.
For this price. I'll want more next time.
What? CTU, put down your weapon.
Get over. Oh.
What? Oh. What? I don't understand.
Get away. I haven't done anything.
Out of my way. CTU! Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent! Take cover!
Did that box hurt me?
Federal agent!
Oh, so look at that. There's something blocking each stairway. And all right, I'll restrain whoever this is.
CTU! Federal agent! CTU!
There. I don't know, what am I doing that I'm hurting everybody? Like, why are these people attacking me?
Federal agent, take cover!
Buffer.
CTU!
Whoa. I'll take that.
Tony, we have a team on their way to your location.
I'm
Tell
good.
Tell them to meet me at Li Jin Yu's room. I'll call you later and let you know what we find.
Okay.
Get over!
I feel like I'm just robbing people.
Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent!
What's a health station, anyway?
CTU! Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent! CTU!
Oh, careful.
Remain calm.
Chill out.
Fuck you. You chill out. What a jerk.
Chill out.
CTU! Federal agent! CTU!
Over there!
Over where?
Take cover! CTU!
Alright, this is all the way up on me.
I'm hit!
What are you doing here?
I'm hoping whatever cutscene we're going to, this does not match what we're doing, like with all this gunfire and shit. Oh, it's over this way, of course. Thank God for this, like, radar that tells me that there's...
Bastard!
Oh dear, wait. Nice camera, thanks. Yay, I guess that worked. 21!
Mr. Yu? My name is Agent Almeida. I'm a federal agent with Los Angeles County.
Oh, now my team's here.
I need to inform you that I'm taking you into custody.
Also, I killed everyone else in the building. So that took an hour, what we did.
The following takes place between 12
Shut
p.m.
Up, Jack.
And 1 p.m.
Dessler.
Michelle, it's Jack. I'm in Thousand Oaks at a meat processing plant.
Why?
It's the base of the men responsible for the vice president's assassination attempt.
I'll send a team in right now. Give me
the
address.
We followed the guy? Are we done taking that guy in? This is... I don't know what to say. This is so, like, boring that Tony just has to, like, take the guy back. Get to the freeway. Huh? Are those people chasing me, or? Oh. Whoa, what the hell? All right. How is the Chinese guy related to the Mexican gangsters? I don't think... Whoa, I don't think he is. I think they were just in the apartment complex and jerks to me. I thought I was... Isn't there a team with me? Whatever, I guess. Are you terrorists, or...? So, if you want, you can actually get out of the car and shoot these people, but, like, getting hit by a car is kind of like insta-kill. I mean, this game is pretty realistic, I know you're all not surprised by that, but... Alright, we're almost at CTU. I'm gonna guess maybe these people are terrorists, but... Whatever. Just get out. Angry LA drivers, sure. Alright, stop it. Already. This guy, like, alive? I'm right by my counter-terrorist, like, base. I think. Probably like a big, bright... A what? There's more? I thought... Oh, this car is fucked up now. Alright, we're almost at CTU, I guess. Right there, it says CTU. Right here. Oh dear. There. 99? Okay. I don't know what I lost 1% for, but... I have no idea what's going on. So I brought this guy back from his apartment. No comment on that. What happened there?
Were you able to pull anything else off that PDA?
No, nothing. Whoever encrypted it knew what they were doing. Maybe he can shed some light on this.
Almeida.
There's gonna be a sarin gas attack on the metro system. Eddie Kane's got four teams on their way now.
What?
Who is this? Hello? Did you just transfer a call to my office?
No.
What's going on?
I just got a call saying there's going to be an attack on the Los Angeles metro system today.
This story's all over the place.
I didn't say.
That's two anonymous phone calls in one day. How serious do you think this threat is?
I don't know.
Okay. This?
Dispatch bomb squads and hazmat teams to each location.
Dispatching.
I'm going.
I'll have a vehicle waiting for you outside.
I love you.
Who's the lead here?
I am, sir. Agent Lee Bowen.
You have our destination?
Yes, sir.
All right, we have less than 20 minutes.
I don't know who Lee Bowen is.
Ryan Chappelle's
here. Oh, Ryan Chappelle.
What?
Where's Tony?
He's in the field.
He's the jerk boss.
He's the agent in charge. He should be here.
It was unavoidable. Is there something I can do for you?
You can tell me why I wasn't informed of a Mr. Yu being held for questioning in relation to the cargo ship takedown from this morning.
Tony will...
When he arrives, you can tell him that I've taken over the questioning.
Ryan.
Oh,
where
shit.
Is this Mr. Yu?
Will you show Ryan where Mr. Yu is being held?
This is a photo of Eddie Kane. We need to take him as quickly and as safely as possible.
Who?
Once we have the gas canister, bomb squad, and hazmat teams
will take
over.
How did we get the name?
Is all this clear? All right, let's go get
him. Oh, wait. But... I don't know. Everyone's face looks like a melted wax figure. Yeah, I agree with you, honestly.
Okay. You stay up here. Help people out of the station.
Huh?
Don't let anyone else in here.
Alright, so I guess there's gonna be a sarin. I don't understand.
Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent!
Oh, the new sub sound? Yeah, I could do that, yeah. Oh, whoops, wait. Sorry.
CTU, huh? Get down! Federal agent! CTU!
Oops, wrong way.
Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent! Federal agent! Federal agent! CTU!
Sir, uh-oh. Kane's making a run for it!
Federal agent! CTU! Federal agent!
Why was there a terrorist on the tracks there? Uh-oh. Alright, whatever. There is a federal agent CTU button, by the way. It's R2. Forgot about that earlier in the playthrough. Sorry. Two. One. Come on. What?
Harrison, you stay up here. Help people out of the station.
Huh?
Don't let anyone else in.
Remain calm. CTU! CTU! CTU!
Who are you?
Federal agent!
Like that little, like, just brushing him with my foot kind of thing. Yeah, whatever.
Sir, Kane's making a run for it!
I could use a little work. Uh-oh. Maybe I would have seen the train. Oh, he's back? Wait, hold on. Oh, let's see. How do I have only 40 seconds to find him, though?
CTU!
Wait, what?
The canister is in our possession. You are clear to enter. I repeat, the canister is in our possession.
What?
You are clear to enter.
How did the door just fall over?
Entering now.
What? I don't understand. What did Eddie Kane was the canister? This is Tony, by the way, not Jack, just for the record.
This is Michelle.
Kane's been taken down. The canister's being defused right now.
That's the last one. The other three all gave up without a fight.
I wish I could say the same for this one. Look, I'm heading back to CTU. I want to see if Lee Jin Yu can shed some light on any of this.
Tony, there's something you should know.
What? What's that? Ryan Chappelle's here.
Ryan's questioning him already.
What? What's Chappelle doing there?
He heard about Lee Jin Yu being held for questioning and he's taken over.
Okay, look, I'll deal with him when I get back.
Well,
sir,
all right.
The place is deserted. There's no sign of Daniels.
What? I don't understand this plot thread at all.
Dessler.
This place has been cleared out. They knew we were coming.
I have more news. I just got a call about the gas canisters from the metro stations.
What about them?
It wasn't sarin nerve gas.
What was it?
They were intricate smoke bombs marked as if they were sarin.
Has anything else surfaced?
Tony brought in Lee Jin Yu, the missing crewman from the cargo ship, about 45 minutes ago.
Hey, Jack. I found something.
This guy was from the show. I forget his name right now.
Mr. Yu, you want out of here. I want you out of here. I can't do that until you tell me everything. You need to start cooperating.
What? Guy was another agent with Jack. I can't think of his name.
Looks like he's been here for a while. A couple days at least. Dog tags.
It was a setup.
That's Legion Yu?
Can you tell me why there's a photo of you and a copy of the crew manifest on this?
Yes, it is mine. I can give you password. You can see. Then you believe me.
What is the password?
Dessler.
The man you think is Lee Jin Yu is an imposter. Whoever's behind this wanted us to find him and take him in.
Jack, what are you talking about? Ryan's in questioning Mr. Yu right now.
No, we just found Lee Jin Yu's body. He's been dead for several days.
You need
to
place the
man you have under arrest, and you need to do it now.
Okay.
5, 9, 3, 7, 3. Yes.
You need to stop the questioning.
No, I don't. We're finally...
Hello?
Michelle? Uh-oh.
Damn it.
What's happening?
I'm not sure. I'm headed to the tech room to see if I can reset the system from there.
Oh, that password.
Something's going on at CTU. The comm system is down.
Took down their whole comm
system.
Yep.
My system uplink is offline. I found the real Lee Jin Yu dead, so the man Chappelle's questioning is an imposter. And the subway attack diverted every available field agent away from CTU at the same time.
So they put an imposter in an apartment building?
Right, something's going on.
And then we brought the...
May I have your attention?
Uh-oh. What's this? Here's another thing that happens pretty frequently. Is CTU gets taken over. I guess that only happened in the... season 3?
Who's in charge?
Oh, Sean.
Sir?
That guy's in charge.
Hello, Joseph.
Hello, Peter.
Oh, okay.
You did well. Let's get to work.
Oh man, finally we have a story?
The following takes place between 1 p.m. and 2 p.m.
That's right, he gets bombed in season 2. I forgot about that. To, like, limit the response to the...
Have the men search again. I don't want any surprises.
Yes, sir.
This guy's new, by the way.
You should know that this will not be tolerated. The United...
And you should know if you open your mouth again, I'll put a bullet in your head.
How long till we can start the transfer?
The effects from the low-level electromagnetic pulse should break up in 2-3 minutes at the most. The system won't be up and running for a couple of hours.
See, that was a low-level EMP. Nice. I guess. Why didn't they just set it off?
Is there something I can do to help?
No, I'm trying to reset the system.
You're the intern, Kim. Shut up.
What's happening out there?
I don't know. Somehow they bypassed our system. Probably with a low-level EM pulse. It killed power to the entire facility, including early warning security.
Why wasn't the tech room affected?
Tech room's shielded. We need to get out of here. Head to room M3. It's a type of panic room. We'll be safe there.
I think this is the Kim Bauer level. Or no, the Michelle Dessler level. Okay. Alright, so yes, this is an escort mission.
Come on.
Federal agent. Come on!
Stay here.
Come on! Federal agent.
Michelle's a pretty good character in the show. I don't have any... Well, I mean, you know. I don't know what's supposed to happen here. Why is the game... Oh, let's use a device. What? But why?
What's the status of the other sectors?
Intruder!
Wait, not an intruder. I work here.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing? I work here. Oh my god.
What are you doing here?
Follow me. Federal agent. Federal agent. CTU.
Thanks, Michelle.
You're welcome. Who are you?
Bitch.
What? Sorry, the camera is not great. What about all these other people? Why am I only escorting Kim, the intern? Alright, the real reason, of course, is because, you know, nepotism. Jack will kind of put national security a little bit at risk for his family, but typically you won't, like, out and out go against the country or something. You know? It's just, you know... Wants to make sure they're okay.
You come any closer and I shoot.
I thought I got him.
Over there.
Oh, get him! Huh? What?
Hey!
I'm it!
Sorry, Kim.
What are you doing here?
Why do they keep asking me that? Okay, so here's Alicia Cuthbert, aka Kim Bauer's deal. Alicia Cuthbert is a very attractive actress. They kind of wanted to keep her on for season 2 of 24. Where she was Jack's kidnapped daughter in season 1. She kind of had no reason to be in season 2, but they, you know, they wanted her on the show. So how do you get a character like that on the show? What you do is you have a nuke go off in Los Angeles, and you have Kim Bauer in Los Angeles, so Jack is not only saving the whole fucking city, but also his daughter, blah, blah, blah. Here's the question. If your father is a counter-terrorist operative, and he knows a nuclear device is going off that day, he's probably going to tell you, which Jack does in, like, the first episode. So the question is, why is Kim...
What are you doing here?
Why is Kim Bauer still in Los Angeles with a nuclear device? And the way the show answers that is by giving her, like, a series of unfortunate events that just keeps happening. In the middle of something, Kim. Kim!
I'm scared. I know. Scared. Just stay close. Once we get to M3, we'll be safe.
So, like... It just so happens the day of this terrorist attack, Kim is, like, babysitting, more or less, this, for this couple, and the husband is like this abusive dickhead, so she's trying to save the little girl in the relationship. At one point, the husband's like tracking her down, they steal the husband's car, but oh, it turned out he killed his wife, and then they get pulled over, and she and her boyfriend get pulled over. And then the cop thinks that they killed the mother, so they get arrested. On the way, there's a car accident with the cop, and then Kim Bauer manages to escape the crashed vehicle. And then she's out in a field, and she gets her leg caught in a cougar trap, and there's a cougar stalking her. Then she's saved by this survivalist guy, who's played by Matt Dillon's brother. Is it Kevin Dillon? And he's kind of creepy and weird, but ultimately lets her go and is not a terrible guy. And that's how you keep Kim Bauer in peril. You just keep having these weird things. So in season 3, she suddenly works for CTU with Jack Bauer, and that way they can put her on the show and stop doing all this contrived shit. But of course, you know, bad shit happens.
Miss Desler, help!
Huh? Hey. What? Oh. Dick. Camera's. Maybe I should go back to that health thing.
What are you doing here?
Why is everyone asking me that?
I'm hit the pool.
Hey!
Shit.
Who are you?
Hey! Oh. Alright, let's see how far back they put me. I feel like I lost Kim, also. For those of you who are just like, the cougar scene is not interesting. The cougar scene is just like literally her getting caught in this trap. It was like, at this point in 24, you're like, season 2, you're like, the show is so good, I can't believe, oh, the Kim Bauer shit, here we go. And then she gets caught in the cougar trap, and you're like, alright, that's enough, 24. Like, that's like the final straw where you're like,
bitch.
So, in season 1, there was an amnesia subplot, which a character sees what she thinks is her daughter dying, and then she's like, I don't remember who I am. Now, what's going on there is that's apparently a rare but like actual thing that can happen where if you're in some kind of trauma, you can have this very temporary sort of fugue state, which happens to the character and is more or less there to kind of give her some backstory. It's a little awkward. It's maybe the worst thing about season 1, but yeah, you know. It's not as bad as the cougar thing.
What are you doing here?
Anyway, yeah, so like I said, yeah, something always bad in a season of 24. Kim Bauer is it. Her entire plot thread is it in season 2. Season 1, she's kind of damsel in distress sort of character, whatever. Alright, there's room M3, I guess. Hey, 90%. I don't know how I got that.
Stop right there!
Uh-oh.
You're coming with us.
After all that, we got kidnapped anyway, but at least Kim Bauer got into the room. The intern. Chase has landed, apparently, I guess.
Yeah.
Dad, something happened at CTU. There are men with guns.
I'm right outside, sweetheart. Are you safe?
Yeah, but Michelle was taken away. I think they have everybody. She said there was an EM pulse that took out the system.
Kim says they've used an electromagnetic pulse to take out the early warning security.
Whoever's in there can take whatever classified information they want.
Sweetheart, where are you?
A room called M3.
Good. Stay there. You'll be safe. It's like a panic room. Once you're locked in, no one will even know you're there.
Is Kim the only one not being held?
Kim is not putting her life on the line.
Now, you know as well as I that if that information gets out, a lot of undercover agents' lives are at stake. Kim.
Sounds good.
I need you to go to the data room. I'll talk you through it.
Okay, I'm ready.
So, again, Jack Bauer risked national security by telling his daughter there is a nuclear device in Los Angeles set to go off that day,
Kim,
but here...
There's a taser in the room. I want you to take it. You may need it. The data room is on the third floor. You need to take the stairwell. It's not far from the M3.
But here, Jack's kind of just okay with her doing whatever. All right, Kim Bauer gets a stun gun. Kim Bauer is, well, the worst character in the game when it comes to...
I'm with CTU.
What?
I'm with CTU. I'm with CTU.
Oh, boy.
I'm with CTU.
Oh, my God. Yeah, stealth section.
What imagines plans now that we're all in CTU?
I'm with CTU.
You know, Madsen, he likes to keep his cards close to his chest.
Sure. I just do what he tells me.
I'm with CTU.
Good.
I'm with CTU.
Details.
This is the stealth section.
Hey! I'm with CTU. Tony, the door's locked to the security panel. It looks kind of broken.
You should be able to short out the circuit and open the door using
CTU.
Your PDA.
I'm with CTU.
PDA? Guy right there.
I'm with CTU. I'm with CTU.
Right, here we go. Guy right here, though. Not?
Hey!
Oh. I'm with CTU. I'm with CTU.
Am I supposed to get...
Tony, I'm on the third floor.
Okay, I want you to head to the main server room. You should be able to cut through it.
I'm with CTU.
Annoying split screen. Uh-oh.
I'm with CTU.
Hey!
Yeah, let's switch to a weapon.
The door's locked. I can't see a way in.
All right, you'll have to go another way. Head on into the next room. It's under construction.
What's the next room? This one?
Tony, there's people here. I'm not sure I can sneak past them.
I think that room has air vents. The safest option would be to crawl through them.
Okay. I'm with CTU. I'm with CTU.
Got it.
I'm with CTU.
Thank you, Kim. All right, that's me doing that. There's giant air vents. Oh, all right. Wait. Okay, this is incredible. Left on the left stick turns you right, and vice versa. I'm not joking. That forward is forward, but the horizontal... controls are reversed.
They'll take you over to the other side of the floor.
Wow, that's... Wait, now it's okay. Wait, no, it's not.
You've got to be quiet moving through the vents.
The controls are... I don't know what the hell. Can't yell, I'm with CTU in here. left was wait, huh? All right, I'm holding right on the stick, and I'm holding left on the stick. It's okay. I get it. It gets really confused around corners. Is the trick. Now it's like normal. Wait, no, right also turned me left. I don't understand the point of the split screen there. Well, now you tell me.
I'm with CTU.
Kind of amazing that, like, that doesn't alert the guards or anything.
Don't shoot!
Screw you!
What? Don't shoot, screw you! Okay. Go slow. All right. Don't shoot.
I'm with CTU.
I never knew she said that before. All right.
I'm out of the vents.
Okay. You're doing well. It's not far now. You just need to find a safe route to the bullpen.
Yeah, I'm not supposed to go in here at all. Supposed to go up and to the left. It's just guy there, though. Oh, he's going another way. All right. Thanks, radar. I feel like the radar makes the game way too easy, but. Barely watching now. Let's see here.
Don't shoot!
Don't shoot! Don't shoot! Hey!
How did she have handcuffs? That's kind of great, honestly.
Hey, anything going on here?
No, nothing. All the remaining CTU agents have been picked up.
Good. Oh. Let's go make a sweep of the second floor.
Okay.
I'm not afraid of you.
Uh-oh. Aw.
Intruder!
Intruder? All right, let's try that again. All right. Oh, don't make me do the vents again. I don't know. Oh, are they gonna make me do the fucking vents again? Jeez, with CTU.
Take her out!
Easy, Fadisha. It seems like you can sprint with X. Go, my God.
I'm with CTU.
Huh? Nothing. What's that?
Nothing. Don't punch the vent. I didn't even slow down at all for that. Too late, game. Let's see if that works a second time.
Surrender.
I'm with CTU.
Music is not really fitting.
Hey, anything going on here?
No, nothing. All the remaining CTU agents have been picked up.
Good. Let's go make a sweep of the second floor.
Can't see anything.
Okay.
Guys are not leaving.
I'm with CTU.
My God, this is ridiculous.
I'm in the bullpen, Tony.
The data room's on the upper level, but you'll need a key first. There's one on my desk in my office.
Where is your office? Other way, okay. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Why is it all smoky in here? Maybe the bomb or the EMP or whatever. There's nobody in here, right? Why does that work? Who the hell knows? Got it. Not too bad for zero. I captured two guys.
Okay, I'm here.
All right, you should see computer monitors with a security prompt.
It looks like data's being uploaded from a secure set of files.
You're gonna have to override the system and stop the upload by encrypting the main hard drive.
Really? Encrypting the main hard drive during...
The data flow. It stopped.
What?
We'll start it again. We're being blocked.
Let's get out of here while we still can. We've done what we came to do.
Don't tell me what we came to do. I'll let you know when we're done here.
By now they know their download stopped. It's not a stretch to assume that they'll start searching every inch of CTU until they find the problem.
We can't just rush in
there,
Jack.
They just stood there?
You know as well as I do what's at stake. That's why I'm saying we need to...
Oh, I gotta get this, Tony. Like, why didn't they do that on the way?
Tony? It's Sean.
Sean, what the hell's going on in there?
Agent Almeida, we have a real problem. Somebody here has something I want, and if I don't get it soon, I'm gonna start making your people drop.
We can work something out, all right? I don't want anybody getting hurt.
Too late for that. Somewhere in this building is a hard drive that I want, and I will start killing your people one every 10 minutes until I get it. Starting now.
Hello?
Who would have thought Sean, Hello? The character Dad, introduced just Sean. For this game, would be kid dead.
They want the hard drive.
What if I put one of the trackers from the data room on the hard drive? I'll turn myself in and they'll take
no.
the drive and then they won't be tracked.
No, listen
to
me, Kim. You need to stay where you are. There's no other choice.
Yes, there is.
Kim.
You're an intern, Kim.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
That was not 10 minutes.
Time's up, people.
Here.
Huh? It's my lucky day.
This is it.
And what's your name?
Kim.
Well, Kim, you just saved her life.
You have it?
We have it.
Can they track it?
Scan it for trackers.
Oh, no.
We got one.
It's clean. Well, you weren't so smart, were you, Kim?
Kim Bauer?
Kim Bauer.
You found yourself quite a little prize, haven't
Uh-oh.
You?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, and I have plans for her.
Don't underestimate Jack Bauer. He's...
I know all about Jack Bauer. He's not gonna be a problem.
You know where to send the files I want?
Don't worry, you'll get them. She's our ticket out of here. Let's go.
What about us?
What about you?
You're not gonna screw us, Peter.
Yeah, Peter. Oh, Peter. What? Ask them not to shoot.
Just get here. We'll be ready.
The roof.
All right. So. All right, Mads.
Heavy weaponry to take out that chopper.
All right then. I guess we're taking out a chopper.
What a bastard!
CTU, drop your weapon!
I'm hit!
CTU, federal agent, CTU.
Who are you?
One of my favorite lines for some reason in season 3 is that somebody says like, hey, you can't do that, and he's like, shut up, stupid! It's just a very... Even for Jack Bauer, it's a very blunt one. I'll take that. And I'll use it. Or not. Oh, I think I still have body armor on.
federal agent.
All right, so, you know.
You bastard! Intruder!
How did he shoot me? He shot and put it in the wrong direction. Whatever. Let's see here. Well, the music got all like kinda good.
The armory's on the third floor. I should head there first.
CTU. Federal agent.
Everything happens on the third goddamn floor of CTU.
CTU.
I do like working for
federal agent.
Fuck.
CTU, federal agent.
Really only recorded the two things? Anyway. Yeah. Oops. Can we get a mod of this game, which he says no?
Because the passcode for this door should be 710538.
Why? Do you remember the thing we just told you?
Jack, the chopper's less than 2 minutes out. You better get to the roof.
All right, cleaned out their armory, I guess. Back in, like, 90s games, too, taking out a helicopter by yourself was always, like, the thing you had to do.
I'm hit!
What are you doing?
Why does everyone, like, not know what I'm doing?
What are you doing here?
Oh. Done.
Tony, I'm on the roof, but Madsen's men are here. I'm taking fire.
Jack, you should see the chopper any time now. Do not allow it to land.
All right. Oh. Where's the helicopter? Oh, there it is. Not a great camera. Oh. Try that again. How do we have the ammo for this? Well, we have, we raided the armory. I press square, for the record.
Tony, I'm on the roof, but Madsen's men are here. I'm taking fire.
Jack, you should see the chopper any time now. Do not allow it to land.
Federal agent. CTU. Federal agent.
The LZ is hot. I repeat, the LZ is hot.
CTU.
I don't even hear you, Jack.
Federal agent.
But
federal agent.
Get down there and take him out.
Wait, what? I was not supposed to let it land, right? Wasn't that the whole thing with it?
Pulling back.
Hey, I guess. Lower the rating. I have no idea.
We're taking damage. I repeat, we're taking damage.
No one else in CTU has guns? What about Tony, even? Shit, shit, shit. Fuck you. Wait. Thank you for putting a fucking clip in it. Christ, alright. Do I have a better weapon than this? I don't have any. Land? Oh. Oh, that was just telling me I did it. Right. It's a lazy afternoon. Actually, the helicopter fight and fear effect was better.
Dad!
You've got what you want. Just let her go.
You didn't get what you wanted.
I don't think so, Jack. You've destroyed our only way out of here. Now she's the only thing I have to guarantee us leaving here in one piece. You follow, she dies.
No!
How do you know that, Agent?
He and I have a history.
Well, that history could become a problem.
As long as we have his daughter, he's no threat to us.
Plans have what? Changed.
Tony, they headed down the east fire stairs, but they could be anywhere at this point.
All right, we'll head them off.
Tony, they've got Kim.
Hey, it's Chase.
Go.
Fun fact. In season, I think that's Chase. In season 3, Chase and Kim are dating, actually. And Chase is Jack's partner. Woo. Huh?
CTU will have ID'd us. We need to change vehicles. There's a car stashed in an alley off Argyle Avenue. Get us there now.
All right. I'm going to be nice and inconspicuous. Noel, why'd you hire her as an intern? Because such bad things were happening to her in the first 2 seasons, you wanted to keep an eye on her. Really it. Right? else is it that she's... That's a good point, honestly, because... That's the thing, you can kind of see where the game was supposed to be, like, kind of like, you know...
Hurry up before LAPD blocks the roads.
I'm trying. You can kind of see where they had that little, like, Grand Theft Auto influence, but... I don't know why they did. This game is very, like, it's very clearly not, like... The 24-hour thing doesn't work with that. Open world kind of shit. I know I keep saying that, but it is just, it frustrates me. Why are the cops chasing us? Because we are escaping from CTU after blowing it up? Look, I don't know. Yeah, we blew that car up.
We're over now.
So anyway, that is one very easy way to get the cops off your back in this game. Okay. It is kind of a bug. If you are being pursued by the cops and you kill the cops, there's no, like, wanted meter or anything. We're good. I thought Kim was... Oh, wait, but there is a pursued meter. What the... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what that deal with the pursued meter is there.
Get a move on.
Crying. Oh. Apprehending. I don't understand where the hell I am and... I'm supposed to go in relation to that.
Lose the cops or take a bullet. Your choice.
Oh, okay. We have to lose the cops. Got it. All right, so.
Watch out! Hey, watch out!
Let's see how we're gonna lose the cops here. Apprehending. Wouldn't it be good if we got caught by the cops in this scenario? I guess they'd kill Kim, I don't know. Yelling federal agent is why the cops want us. Drive around the block. The cops won't know what hit them.
Drive faster or I'll shoot you and drive myself.
Alright, I'm trying. We're not being apprehended. Oh look, wait. I think I got away from him.
Hey, watch out!
Yay.
Hey, watch out!
Now, another way you can do this, which I was trying to demo, is if you do destroy the cop car, that somehow works too. Ooh, 95, all right.
Look, I still have men searching, but it doesn't look good.
Has everything been locked down?
That electromagnetic pulse took out all of our mainframe TX hubs.
I don't care if it down the entire system.
I know what you want, Jack. And I'm telling you that right now it's not possible. We're not even sure which clusters are operational.
How long?
How long?
I don't know. 7, 8 minutes maybe.
Do what you can.
All right. Blue, red, or green cubes. Got it.
I'm gonna need to repair the corrupted sectors before we can initiate the reboot.
Damn it. So this part kind of blows. We're not hacking, we're repairing. There's a difference? Ah, sorry. So, can't yell federal agent on this one. Alright. Yes, this is how computers work.
Tony, I'll need the new reboot passcodes.
I've got them here. 3720092.
This is not count as a mini game.
8915568.
Why don't you just enter them, Tony? What? Network scan. Move to that node. A contact with the outside world.
Now I just need to make sure our system has a clear connection with the primary external network.
Forward, left, left. Damn it. This has all the intense action of dialing a phone number from a book. And so stupid. I am curious what kind of like thing we're unlocking here.
Things are up and running now.
Are we at full
done.
Capacity?
No, there was too much damage.
Any sign of them?
None. I'm showing there was a breach in the northeast corridor.
It's Bauer.
Kim,
where are you?
Hello, Jack.
What do you want, Madsen?
I want you to know that I have your daughter. And that she's safe.
You son of a bitch, if you touch her, I'll...
You what, Jack? You gonna make me pay? Kill me? I got news for you. My days of taking orders from you are over.
What do you want?
The only reason your daughter is still alive is because she was smart enough to have encrypted the hard drive before handing it over to me.
Dun, dun, dun.
I now need the hard drive decrypted. There are only two places in Los Angeles that can do this quickly without data loss. The first is CTU, which we both know isn't running at full capacity. The second is the agency's branch in Los Angeles. Drive there.
Wait, I'm in Los Angeles.
And Jack, the clock is ticking.
The following takes place between 3 p.m. and 4 p.m.
Stop at some point tonight.
His real name is Joseph Sin Chung, Korean-American. He's a technical expert specializing in circuit technology. One arrest 6 years ago for breaking and entering, got probation. Other than that, looks like he's kept his nose clean.
Or was too smart to be caught.
Wait. Decode the hard drive. Wasn't this made on a computer? Alright then.
What do you want, Madsen?
You haven't changed a bit, Jack. You're still the same old patriotic son of a bitch you always been. Risking your life for people who could give a rat's ass about you.
Oops.
Let me ask you a question. Has it paid off? Huh? Are you where you thought you'd be after all these years?
Madsen?
Why do I find that hard to believe?
I don't care what you believe.
Well, you should. I have your daughter. And to be honest, if I were you, I'd be a little more than worried. I'm sure she's a good sport, though, eh, Jack?
If you touch her, I'll kill you.
Pipe down, Jack. You had your chance 8 years ago, and you didn't take it. You didn't kill me then, and you can't kill me now. Even if you
got
the opportunity, I don't believe you'd take it. You know why?
I bet I would.
Because you haven't changed.
I bet I have.
8 years, and you haven't changed one bit.
I probably have. You haven't seen me in 8 years.
You always have, but at the end of the day, when all the smoke's cleared, you still have to answer to the people who sign your paycheck. Isn't that right, Jack?
You got my number. Now, is that good?
8 years ago, my family wasn't involved.
Is that the line that I have to cross? What about due process? What about being innocent until proven guilty? What about all that crap that you so desperately fight for?
I do?
Let me talk to my daughter.
That's not an option. You know that. Just knowing your daughter, Kim, is it?
Yes.
Just know Kim's doing just fine. You don't have anything to worry about.
Thank you.
In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if after everything is said and done, she didn't want to leave.
That's doubtful.
So let's not talk about that anymore. Okay, Jack?
We need to match the subtitle.
Good.
Okay, thank you. Seems nice. 95% for that. I drove. That took 10 minutes? Yeah, Jack does kill people all the time.
When you're in the building, you'll need to find a data terminal. Use it to access the directory files. You must find the directory file that will give you access to the decryption program I need.
What's the file name?
43prog.dcr. I'll give you more information once you have the program in your possession.
One more thing. It's up to you on how you get in. But if you're caught, your daughter dies. I'll be in contact.
Right. So, this, if I remember, is like the only...
This is a high-security building. They'll never let me in.
Looks like you're gonna have to be creative.
This is the only section of the game I remember liking, because this felt like the show.
I'm visiting your office. I need a visitor's pass, please.
Oh, are you with the interdepartment tour?
Yes, I'm with that tour.
You're running a bit late. They've already gone through.
I got held up at the airport.
Did you get stuck in security? It's been pretty tight there recently.
Why are we both rocking back and forth? Look at that.
Since I'm already late, can I please just have my pass?
Your pass? Ah, this must be it, Mr. Linnell.
No, that's not my name.
Well, it's the only name I have. We have very strict security measures here.
Not really.
If this isn't your name, we can't let you in. Sorry.
It's very careless, Jack. Now Kim will pay the price.
Oh, all right. So that's kind of ridiculous, but we have very high security, but... Anyway, time paradox, because Kim Bauer is alive for season 3. It was DCR, it was the file extension that is not one... All right, this is creeping the fuck out of me.
This
My neighbors across
building.
The street
let me
have this window with, like red curtains, and there's a goddamn silhouette of, like, a head. I don't know if it's watching me or what. Like, a black silhouette on totally red-lit-up, like, windows. It is fucking freaky. I kind of want to take a picture in a way, but... Let me just do that really quickly, because it is fucking creeping the shit out of me.
They don't realize I'm doing it. Showing up white. That's so fucking creepy.
Okay, anyway. Where were we?
I'm visiting your office. I need a visitor's pass, please.
Oh, are you with the interdepartment tour?
Yes, I'm with that tour.
You're running a bit late. They've already gone through.
Since I'm already late, can I please just have my pass?
Your pass? Ah, this must be it, Mr. Linnell.
Yes, Mr. Linnell.
Okay, well, here's your pass.
Thank you.
We don't allow visitors to take weapons into the building. You can hand in any weapons to me.
Here's my handgun.
Thank you. Now you're all set to go.
Why would that? That's not like a normal thing for office buildings.
Remain
calm. As you can see, the building has gone recently.
Oh, whoops. Damn it.
It was a huge upheaval for us, but I'm sure you'll agree it was worth it.
This is a high security building. They'll never let me in.
Looks like you're gonna have to be creative.
I'm visiting your office. I need a visitor's pass, please.
Oh, are you with the interdepartment tour?
Yes, I'm with that tour.
You're running a bit late. They've already gone through.
Since I'm already late, can I please just have my pass?
Your pass? Ah, this must be it, Mr. Linnell.
That was awesome!
Yes, Mr. Linnell.
Okay, well, here's your pass. We don't allow visitors to take weapons into the building. You can hand in any weapons to me.
Here's my handgun.
Thank you. Now you're all set to go.
Do this the right way now.
Ah, here's our missing group member. Well then, let's move on, shall we?
It's a good thing there was happened to be someone who actually was late.
Oh, you joined a tour group. Nice thinking. Now don't do anything stupid that's gonna get your daughter killed. You're gonna collect some things from me. Stay with the group for now.
I know how to do this. Wow, this kind of sucks, actually. I don't remember why I like this.
Okay, let's stop here for a moment.
Okay, Jack. Here's your first task. Get over to those staff lockers under the balcony. Don't draw any attention to yourself. I need you to find an ID card. Head to the middle bank of lockers. It's in one of them. The combination
is
892.
We have a state-of-the-art high-resolution video screen on the wall above the podium. Take a few minutes to explore, and then we'll continue on. Okay, people, gather around, and we'll continue on.
Who would let you explore in, like, such a high-security thing?
Is everyone here? Okay, that's everyone. Please follow me.
Person, by the way, in the silhouette, like, left when I took the picture, so. They're coming to kill me now. This is a lot like Mission Impossible 64. No elevator? Nobody's talking on the tour? This is a pretty dull tour, I totally agree. I don't even know what we're touring.
We'll stop here, just outside the security manager's office.
Get into the security manager's office and access the computer.
We have a nice view of the briefing hall from here.
Good thing we stopped outside there.
Human resources management are housed.
CTU.
This is the newly developed HR 3000
Federal agent.
To track the comings and goings of our staff,
Okay, Jack. Access the level 4 security staff log and add the name on your badge to the list.
It's vital we are aware of how all our staff are performing and identify any problems as early as possible. This software helps us to do that and to date has been working very effectively.
Done, I guess.
We'll break for a moment before moving on. Okay, are we ready to move on?
What?
I'll just do a quick head count.
I'm here.
Good, that's everyone. Follow me.
I'm not suspicious. Don't blow your cover, Mr. Liddell. Ooh, oops. Go up to the third floor. Boy.
Be careful you aren't seen by any security cameras when you're not with the group.
Yes, sir. We'll just stand in this
room. Let's make another stop.
Already?
Jack, you need to take the security card from one of the guards. How you get it is up to you. Remember, your daughter's life is on the line here.
To control and track all our security cameras. We used an earlier version of the system before and upgraded to their latest system during our remodel. As I'm sure you are all aware, building security is a high priority for us. As we move through our final stage of the tour, we'll be going past the offices of some of our...
Oh, I gotta hide the body.
I'm sure you'll understand if we don't go in and disturb them.
There you go. I don't know where that security camera is supposed to be pointing.
Okay, then shall we move on?
Oh, there it is.
Hey, is everyone here?
I'm here.
Good. Let's go.
Oh, I wasn't okay. This group will help me get past the security camera. Perfect. What next, Madsen? Like tension music, and I don't really know why.
All that time I took orders from you, how does it feel to be on the receiving end for a change?
Is that boring? I'm sorry, Madsen, I really am.
Girl, Jack. One of my men's already taken quite a shine to her.
They gonna go out? Really? Let's stop.
And that concludes the tour. Feel free to take advantage of our cafeteria. If you have any questions,
there's nothing here.
Use the elevators through the far.
Leave the tour group here, Jack.
Thank you for visiting us.
We need to get into the high security area. You should have everything you need to get past the guard.
Alright, I'm just gonna blend in. Hey.
Sir, I need to see your security pass.
I'm hiding.
Okay, then all seems in order.
There you go.
Let me make sure your name's on my access log.
Mr. Linnell.
Oh, right, here it is. David Linnell. Huh. I haven't seen you before. Do you, know your way around?
Yes.
I'll be fine, thank you.
All right, then. Have a nice day.
You got it. Don't mind my skulking.
You're doing well, Jack.
You need to get a sat link cable from the equipment room.
Yeah. Sorry.
Equipment monitored by heat sensors. Unless you keep moving, your body heat will raise the temperature and trigger an alarm.
I don't want to be in that room anyway, yet. That link cable thing. Don't mind me, pal. Stupid. Ooh, come on. X circle. No, the way neighbor's not watching anymore. That was kind of freaky. Don't mind me. Really? Body heat crap, cool off. No, hey, no, use the computer, Jack. Little run he's got is ridiculous. Done. Just jogging. Okay, now can we... What? Oh, okay.
Okay, now hook your PDA up to the base terminal of the satellite dish.
Cool, now we're gonna help the terrorists.
Ready to upload? To avoid being tracked, I will ask you to change frequency while the program uploads. Now, okay. Enter the following frequency. 436-900. 7921113.
This is not a mini game.
053209. 6.
Oh, my God.
023.
Jack never before just out and out helped terrorists to say whatever.
291. Thank you, Jack.
Done. All right, I think that's... Well, I guess we'll watch this cutscene and then call it, right?
My father will find me.
Willie, program's been uploaded. Start the decryption. Very good, Jack. Your assistance won't be needed any longer. Thanks for your help.
Where's my daughter?
With me. I know it kills you to think about what I could do to her.
I swear to God, Madsen, if you touch her...
You better be careful, Jack. You're in a very precarious position.
You better hope I'm not the one who finds you.
You don't scare me, Jack.
How do I... Well, how do you stop playing?
The following take...
No, okay. Between four. Save the game. Unfortunately, for those of you who said, wait, we skipped the cutscene, there's... We can fortunately do... Previously on 24, which is a cool kind of thing that they did on the show, right? Wait, that's it? Alright, whatever. Before we go, though, there is one last thing we should do.
24 Season 4 on DVD.
There's a nuclear warhead gonna detonate somewhere over this country. No!
Get even more with an exclusive prequel that
right.
Clues you in to next season. 24 Season 4. Own it today.
Alright, take it easy, everybody.